Hello, my dear students. Welcome to today's session of online class of Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. Students, we are going to start a new chapter today. Chapter 17, Rectification of Errors. You all know that trial balance, which is a statement of debit and credit balances of ledger account. Trial balance is prepared to check the arithmetical accuracy of books of accounts. This is based on the principle that in double entry system, for every debit there is a corresponding credit of equal amount and vice versa. So we know that trial balance, which follow the double entry system, and in double entry system debit is equal to credit with equal amount. So if both are of equal amount, we can say that trial balance is showing a correct figure, that is, it is arithmetically correct. However, a matched trial balance is not a conclusive proof of the complete correctness of the books of account. So if a trial balance is showing debit equal to credit, that does not mean it's a conclusive proof of a complete correctness of a books of account. Sometimes it may happens that even if the trial balance is tallying, or even if the trial balance debits and credit side is equal, it may show a incorrect details. Even when the trial balance matches, some errors may still remain in the accounting record. So this means when the trial balance matches, some errors may still remain in the accounting records. So even if the trial balance is showing a matching figure, sometimes it may happens that there may be some errors in the accounting records. Errors can be classified into four types. The first one is error of omission, second one is error of commission, third one is error of principle, and fourth one is compensating errors. Let us have a detailed look on each of these errors. First one is error of omission. A transaction, if completely or partially omitted for being recorded in the books of account, is categorized as an error of omission. Omission means we have forgotten or we have not recorded completely or partially some of the transaction. That is known as error of omission. So as I discussed that it may be of two types, error of complete omission or error of partial omission. What is error of complete omission? This arises if a transaction is not recorded in the books of accounts, or a transaction recorded in the journal is not posted in the ledger. Such error do not affect the trial balance. So children, when the transaction is not recorded in the books of account, it is known as complete omission. So in case of complete omission, trial balance will not be affected. Okay, so that means your trial balance will be showing a correct figure. So it will not affect your trial balance. So you have to be very careful with the complete omission type of error. Okay. Next is error of partial omission. This is an error where a part of transaction and not the complete transaction is omitted to be recorded. So sometimes we may have recorded the debit aspect and we have forgotten to record the credit aspect. So what happens? It is a partial omission. One part of that transaction is recorded, the other part of that transaction is not recorded. So I hope you understood the error of partial omission. Such error results in the trial balance not agreeing. So that means trial balance will be affected in case of partial omission. So trial balance will not tally. Debit side will not be equal to credit side if it is an error of partial omission. Okay, so this was first type of error, that is error of omission. Next is error of commission. Error of commission are those errors which arises due to wrong recording, wrong posting, wrong carry forward, wrong casting of subsidiary books and wrong balancing, etc. So if these are the cases, then we will term that error as error of commission. Now some of the examples of error of commission are error of recording, error of casting, error of carrying forward, error of posting. In error of casting and error of carrying forward, it will affect the trial balance. Okay, and error of recording and error of posting, that will not affect the trial balance. I hope it's clear to you. The third type of error is error of principle. When a transaction is recorded in contravention of accounting principles, it is known as error of principle. So we know that there are certain principles of accounting. Okay, in our chapter 2, we have studied about the error principles of accounting. So if we are recording the transaction as against these principles, it is known as error of principles. We have to follow that principle when we are recording the transaction in the books of account. If we are not following that principles while recording the transaction, it will be termed as error of principle. Such error do not affect the trial balance as amount are placed on the correct side but it in a wrong account. So amount posting will be done correctly. In this case, error of principle, amount posting will be done correctly. So our debit side and credit side will tally with a correct amount, but the account will be wrongly placed. Okay. Now, fourth category of error is compensating error. Now, what is this compensating error? Compensating errors are those errors in which effect of one error is nullified by the effect of another error. So, when in case of one error, to hide the one error, we go for another error. Okay, so hiding for purpose of hiding one error, when we go for another error, it is a case of compensating errors. Compensating errors also do not affect the trial balance. So these are the four categories of errors. Beside the above classification of errors, these errors may be categorized into following two categories also. Okay, that is error affecting the trial balance, which is also known as one-sided error, and there are errors not affecting the trial balance or two-sided error. We already discussed the errors which affect the trial balance and the errors which do not affect the trial balance. So you have to understand that error affecting the trial balance is also known as one-sided error. That means only one side your account have been posted wrong. Okay, and errors not affecting the trial balance, two-sided error. Okay, now what are error affecting the trial balance or one-sided error? Errors affecting the trial balance are those errors which affect only one account and thus trial balance do not match. So if only one side of that account is posted wrong, then it will be termed as one-sided error. And you have to understand that trial balance will not match in one-sided error. So here are some examples of one-sided errors. The first one is posting only one aspect of the journal entry in the ledger. So children, if a transaction is in such a way that you have purchased some goods for rupees 10,000. So purchase account debited to cash account. But when this journal entry is posted to ledger, you may have recorded purchase but cash was not recorded. So what happened? Your ledger will not be correctly posted. And from ledger, when you show it in trial balance, what happens? The trial balance will show that difference. Okay, so that is known as one-sided error. That is, only one aspect of journal entry have been posted to ledger and the other side aspect is not recorded. Now, posting a journal entry on the wrong side of an account, that is a journal entry, if it is posted on the wrong side of that account, then it will be termed as one-sided error. Then error in carrying forward, that is carried down, is brought down next accounting year. In that case, if you are posting it in wrong way, then it will be termed as one-sided error. Now, there are errors which are known as two-sided error or error not affecting the trial balance. So, error not affecting the trial balance are those errors which do not affect the agreement of trial balances. Such errors are not disclosed by the trial balance. So, those errors which are not affecting the trial balance and which are not disclosed by the trial balance is also known as two-sided errors. Some of the examples of two-sided error are error of principle, error of complete omission, compensating errors, and posting correct amount on the correct side but in wrong accounts. So these are some of the examples of two-sided error. Both debit and credit aspect have gone wrong. So that is a case of two-sided error. Now, don't you feel that errors have to be corrected? So, our lesson is all about this. Correcting the error is known as rectification of errors. Errors, whether affecting the trial balance or not, must be detected and corrected. The procedure followed to rectify the error committed and to set right accounting record is called rectification of errors. What is the objective behind rectification of error? The three main objectives is preparing correct accounting records. We want everything in a correct way. So, only when mistakes are corrected, we will get a correct accounting records. The second objective is ascertaining correct net profit or loss for the accounting period by preparing profit and loss account with the correct pictures or figures. So, correct net profit and loss can be ascertained if your recording is correct. Okay. The next third point is exhibiting a true and fair view of financial position. So, to know the financial position, we depend on balance sheet. So, to get a correct balance sheet, we should have a correct accounting data. So, rectification of error will help us to rectify or correct the errors in the accounting works. Okay. So, we have come to a conclusion of today's topic. Today we have discussed about classification of error. We saw four different types of error. We also saw that beside these four classification, there is classification of errors on the basis of one-sided error and two-sided error. So just go through this topic and understand the concept. Attend the test paper attached and send it by 2 o'clock. Meet you in the next class with new topic. Till then, goodbye.